Hello, it's Maureen Legas here with your 21 Days 2018 series, and today is day 12. So today we're going to continue to talk about dot loop. Yesterday we created a loop, we added documents to it, we talked about how to fill them in, we talked about how to share disclosures properly, we talked about sharing these documents. Today we're going to talk about a couple of things. The clause manager, how to make sure you have these clauses. We talked about when we're here in an agreement and we start to type something, that a clause can pop up and we can fill that in. So we're going to talk about the clause manager. We're going to also talk about if we have a PDF, how we can add PDFs to our loop, and then how we can add information and signatures to the PDF. So let's start with the clause manager. So up here at the top of the loop, you have this section called templates. And when I click on templates, it's going to take us over to the template section. And here at the bottom of the list is something called clauses. And when I click on that, you'll see that I have some clauses set up. One of them, Keller Williams Realty Select, which is the name of my office. Another one, when I do addenda and I make any changes, I always finish it with all other terms and conditions of this contract remain the same. So to add a new clause, you click up here, add a clause, and then you want to type something that you frequently type when you are writing contracts. So for example, let's say you're going to put in the things that remain with the house. So generally you would have refrigerator, dishwasher, range, microwave. And some of these might not be the same at every house. Microwave, you might remove some of these for some of the properties. Let's see, washer, dryer, and you might have some others depending on where you are. Let's say I'm going to add that to the clause manager. So now I have these three clauses. So now let's go back to the loop. Click here to go back to my loops. And I go back, select my loop, and then I'm back in here. And let's say I'm going to open up this document again, exclusive right to sell. And then over here where it says appliances included, you want this new clause to appear. Now you can start typing and see if it pops up. It might not be set yet, and it does not pop up. So what I can do is put my mouse here, and over here where it says add clause, see when you roll over all of these, there's information. You can click on add clause. It'll show the clauses. You click on the one you want. Click add, and now that comes in here. And let's say they don't have a microwave, then you could just remove this microwave. And then you still have all of the appliances. So that way you don't have to retype this each time. So that's how to use the clause manager. Now all of these are dot loop documents. We can add to them. There's buttons that are buttons yes that we can check. What if we have a PDF that we want to add? So let's go back and let's look at adding a PDF. So I'm going to click on add document, and then instead of getting it from my templates, I'm going to get it from my computer. So I'm going to click browse, and it will open up a box on your computer that'll let you find the documents you want. I'm going to click these and I'm going to open them, and they're going to add them here to my loop. And again, I can move those wherever I want them. If I want to move them to the bottom, I can do that. You can even move to another folder if you've put them in the wrong folder. So I'm going to take these documents here, and now I'm going to add some. These are PDFs. They're not dot loop documents. I'm going to add some information to that. So I'm going to pick the seller net proceeds, and this is where I'm going to evaluate what the proceeds may be for the seller based on an estimated sales price. So up here under add, you can see there's options. So I'm going to take the date, and I'm going to add the date today. The property address I'm going to add as a text field. I'm going to add, type in the property address. The sales price I'm going to also add as a text field, property address. I mean the estimated sales price. And then I'll go through and add all of these different fields that I need to this document and fill it in. Doc stamps in our area, we divide by 100. and multiply times 70 cents to calculate the dock stamps on the estimated sales price. So you come through all of it, and here at the bottom, you want to add signatures. So I'm going to add a signature field here, and any of these fields, you can alter the size using this little arrow at the side. You can alter the size of the boxes. Same thing for any text boxes that you add here. You can alter the size of the text box. Then you're going to add the seller signature. And when you add the seller signature, you want to assign it to the seller. And we've added two sellers. You can click assign here or click under assign. And Sandra was not the seller number one, so I'm going to do it in the same order. Sandra seller, and add the signature here. And I'm going to change the size, make it a little bit smaller. And then I'm going to add that to Sam. So Sandra and Sam sign. And that's how we're adding boxes for signature. So it's much the same way if you have more than two buyers or sellers. So let's say you're working with an investor. Then you would continue to add signatures for the other sellers. You want to make sure those people have been added. You'd find the next person that you've added to your list of people in the loop and assign it to them. Now, that works with PDF documents. You save it, and now you have the PDF that you can share. If you go back here, you can't add when you have a listing document that's in the .loop format. You can't add any of these things. They're grayed out. You can't add them here. So what you would do is if you have multiple sellers on these documents that are .loop documents, you would take all of those and send them to your first two sellers to sign. You'd share with your first two sellers and have them sign. Once they sign all of the documents, you come back in, and then you would download those documents as a PDF. And then you would add that PDF back into this loop by browsing. And once it's a PDF, then you can go back in, just like we did with the seller net proceeds, and add the additional signatures and send them off to sign. All right, so that's all for today. It's all we're going to talk about .loop. We have a few more things with .loop to discuss tomorrow. So I hope you have a great day.